update on the medium wave radio that I'm working on, going from say 800 kilocycles to approximately 1.8 megacycles. And here you see how I made the second stages. This will be the beat frequency oscillator, because I want to get, if possible, to say 3 megahertz. And then it could be that I need a beat frequency oscillator to receive single sideband signals, CW, etc., etc. And this will be the audio part. Perhaps, say, an audio filter that will filter out noise and say other kinds of strange signals. And then I mean that this filter will be perhaps made specially for the audio band, so that we have a peak reception in the audio band that will be say between 1 kilohertz and approximately 4 kilohertz. So that's the reason why it is as it is. I had some problems with my audio amplifier here. It oscillated. It couldn't give out the right output level, but anyway, everything was cured. And here the new power supply. I've told in the preceding video that I used the BD139 and the BC547. The BC547 as a driver transistor. Well, that was not a good idea. I leave it here as it is, because when you shortcut this circuit, that BC547 is immediately defective. So here we have the better circuit, the 2N3055 and the BD139. It's in many videos on my YouTube channel. So now I'm working at the moment on the VFO, the variable frequency oscillator, that has to do its job between say approximately 800 kilohertz, approximately 3.5 megahertz. I've made a kind of template, perhaps that's interesting to show. So kind of wooden block on which I screw the circuit so that it so that I can punch in all these brass nails. These brass nails with the hammer. Of course, when you do that without say a solid wooden block, everything gets distorted. So this will be the coil for the VFO, the local oscillator. Here are the two diodes that do the job here in the circuit here. This is the circuit, by the way. Again, I published it earlier anyway. This is the circuit of the local oscillator that I will use. And then I'm working on here a kind of sketch of how I wanted to make it. And now it's realized. And of course, in practice, there are always differences. So this was the test circuit. And now I transfer all the components from the test circuit into the definite circuit here. And well, that means that you can see sometimes typical problems that have to do with, say, the translation from the breadboard circuit to the definite circuit. But I'm absolutely sure that it will work. Classic standard problems when you make at first a breadboard circuit and then want to make it in a definite way. Classical problem is oscillations, parasitic oscillations. So that could happen here, but I always make my circuit in such a way that the risk of parasitic oscillations is extremely diminished. And that refers to all my circuits on YouTube. parasitic oscillations are, say, almost never a serious issue. And it's everything to do with proper decoupling. Here, for instance, such a unit here, decoupling unit, prevents the circuit from parasitic oscillations. Anyway, perhaps I'm going to make another video about parasitic oscillations. I made one, but I think it was not good enough. Anyway, working further on this, say, beautiful local oscillator, variable frequency oscillator here, on this definite situation, I found that I had to mount that capacitor. That capacitor is here, this one, because the axis is not very long. So I had to, say, make a hole in the front, and that front is shielded with tin plate. And I made a hole in that front, and of course, in such a situation, there is a risk that you get hand effect. And that's the reason why you see here this tin plate. And you can also see here that the tin plate has a wire, and that wire goes here to the backside, to the shielding. The tin plate shielding that is glued to the triplex multiply wood of 3 millimeters. So that when I say touch the knob in the future, there will be no hand effect, so that the oscillator, the local oscillator, stays on its precise frequency. And here's the fine tuning made with a 1K potentiometer here. It's in the schematic. It's here, 1K potentiometer. So I don't want to make this too long, so the circuit again, schematic again. Thanks for watching. So, a lot to do this evening.